another banger.
Welcome to my channel. It's your boy Al in the building, and I'm back with another video. So in today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys tips, tricks, and advice on how to secure a paid internship. Last week, I posted a video that showed a day in my life as a chemical engineer intern, and today I wanted to just give you guys advice on how I was able to get the internship in. Even if this video does not apply to you, make sure that you watch it, because you never know, you might have a friend or a relative or somebody that needs this advice. So please watch, and also just comment on any topics you would like me to cover in the future or any questions that you have. Without further ado, let's get into the first piece of advice. Make sure that you apply, because the more jobs you apply, the more chances you have to get an interview and to get an internship. That's what I did. So when I was looking for an internship, I made sure I applied to at least a minimum of 5 jobs a day. And if you do the math, 5 times 7 days in a week equals 35. So each week you're giving yourself 35 new opportunities to get an internship. Increase it to 10 if you have to, like 10 times 7, 70 job opportunities a week. Come on, like, that's a win-win. You're going to get rejected. Like, I think I got rejected at least, I don't even know. I lost count because I got rejected so many times. But make sure that when you get rejected, channel that energy into a new application. Make sure you don't let that like get you down, because imagine if Steve Jobs quit when he got rejected, or like Mark Zuckerberg. Imagine if like people like that quit, they wouldn't have gotten anywhere. So make sure that you channel that energy from rejection to just keep on pushing through and keep on applying. Make sure that you try to network and just talk to new people, because you never know what opportunity you might get from talking to someone new. You never know who knows who, like who can give you the connect. Make sure you talk and network with different people, because fam, you will get your foot. Make sure that you join clubs that have to do with your major, because GPA is one thing, but once you have that like technical experience and you're like involved in the club, like fam, they can't take that away from you. Just because you have a 4.0 GPA or 3.5 or any good GPA, people that have a 2.5 GPA are also as intelligent as someone with a 4.0 GPA. So don't like beat yourself up if you have a low GPA, because at the end of the day, that's just one factor in a variety of other factors that help you get an internship. Don't compare your hustle to anybody else's hustle, because just because someone else got an internship at Apple or Google or any other like top company or whatever, that doesn't mean that they're better than you, okay? Let me get that straight. It's okay to start small, because at the end of the day, what matters is the experience and what you're taking out of, you know, the internship. If you're working at an internship or you're applying to a place for the title because it's a big name company, I feel bad for you, because that's just, it's a waste of time. You're just wasting your time, because that's not even the point of it. So yeah, make sure you don't compare your hustle, because at the end of the day, you're the only person that matters. Okay, so that's all the advice I have in this video. Let me know which piece of advice that you're gonna take and use to help you get an internship. Let me know which one you really think would help, which one you don't think would help. Like, let me know down below. And also, like, let me know what other topics that you would like me to cover on the channel. Let me know any questions that you guys have for me in the comment section. I respond to every single comment, and yeah, let me know. Connect with me. It has been your boy Al in the building, and I am signing out. I'ma make up my eye, I'ma need